Okay, good morning friends. In the early sessions, we discuss about the chapter number 11, work and energy. Today we discuss about the activity 11.14. Now in this activity, we have to make the list of human activities and gadgets we use involving conversion of energy from one form to another form. Now first, human activities like running, cycling, swimming, etc. All these are the human activities. Now we discuss about the electric gadgets, that is electric heater, electric cell, electric motor, solar energy, photoelectric cell, dynamo, steam engine. Okay, all these are the electrical gadgets. Now we have to identify the kind of energy conversion that take place. In most of the human activities, the muscular energy gets converted into kinetic energy. In electrical appliances, electrical energy changes into heat energy. Okay, for example, iron, electrical energy convert into heat energy. In a DJ system, DJ, electrical energy convert into sound energy. Electric bulb or electric tube light, electrical energy converted into light energy. Electric fan, electrical energy convert into mechanical energy. Okay, we take more example, solar battery. Solar energy converted into electrical energy. In photoelectric cell, light energy gets converted into electrical energy. Okay. Now we discuss about the law of conservation of energy. Now in previously activities, we discuss about that the form of energy can be changed from one form to another form. Whenever energy gets transferred, the total energy remains unchanged. This is the law of conservation of energy. Now according to this law, energy can only be converted from one form to another form. It can neither be created or destroyed. The total energy before and after the transformation remains the same. Now we consider one example. Let an object of mass m be made to fall freely from height h. Now at the start, the potential energy is mgh and kinetic energy is zero. Kinetic energy is zero because its velocity is zero. The total energy of the object is mgh here. Now as it falls, its potential energy will change into kinetic energy. Okay, if V is the velocity of the object, the kinetic energy would be 1/2 mv². And as the fall of the object continues, the potential energy would decreases while the kinetic energy would increases. Okay, so when the object is about to reach the ground, that is H equal to 0, velocity will be highest. So therefore, the kinetic energy would be the largest and the potential energy will be the least. Now here, the summation, the sum of the potential energy and the kinetic energy of the object would be the same at all the points. That is, potential energy and kinetic energy is constant. Okay, so potential energy equal to mgh and kinetic energy is 1/2 mv² is equal to the constant. So here the sum of kinetic energy and the potential energy of an object is its total mechanical energy. Now we discuss about the rate of doing work. Agents that transfer energy to do work at different rates. Agents that transfer energy to do work at different rates. Now let us consider the activities 11.16. Consider two children, child A and child B. Let us say that their weight is also same. Both start climbing. up a rope separately. Both the reaches at height of the 8 meter. Let us say that child A takes 50 seconds, while child B takes 20 seconds to accomplish the task. What is the work done by each? So here the work done by each child is MGH. The work done is the same. However, child A has taken less time than child B to do work. Who has done more work in a given time, say in 1 second? Child A has done more work than child B in 1 second. We say that child A has more power than B.